Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. And today we are going to be doing a walkthrough for the Minecraft Hour of Code. Now, this is a really good... I should explain what I'm doing here, right? So let's go to View Library. Let's go to Lessons. Let's go to Computer Science and click Hour of Code. There we go. Now, this Hour of Code and Create World. There we go. Now, this particular lesson is supposed to be an introductory lesson onto how to move around in Minecraft. There's NPCs in there that will explain to you where to go and what to do. So you can kind of leave the students alone with this one and hope that they make it through. Although in my experience, it's not always the case. So this is a little tutorial that you can use to help you get through. And also, show you the kind of approved way to complete some of these tasks, because not every task is super intuitive. All right, so current quest is coming up there in the left, so that's saying go talk to the researcher. So it's pretty clear straight ahead we need to move our way forward. We've been spawned in this world here, and we need to make our way over here to get through the gate. Here we go. Right click me, so it's teaching us to talk to NPCs. Welcome to the Research Center. Here you will learn AI and coding to prevent fires. Your first task is to use coding to open this gate. Press C to start coding. Now, depending on the age of your students, they may or may not actually read this and just walk up to the gate, but we do need to encourage them to press C, and it is actually popping up at the bottom. So press C to get coding. Now, for each tutorial, it will load its own, there we go, open the gate. It will load its own set of coding. So here we literally have the two bits of code that we need. And then we press, where it says on start, that means pressing this particular button here. So we press that, and there's the gate all opened up. Okay, now, current quest, talk to the engineer. This is the agent. You can program the agent like you did with the gate. Code the agent to move three steps forward and stop on the marker. All right, then. Again, it's going to load up just the blocks that we need. Very simple stuff. Lovely. And we also get this little help thing at the top. So if we click here, it literally tells us what to do. Drag the agent move forward block from the toolbox into the on start block and change the number of steps from 1 to 3. So do remind your students that they can access this up here. It will tell them exactly what to do. So drag it on, change it to 3, press start. There we go, the agent disappears through the next gate. So let's have a chat with the researcher, which is our current quest. The agent needs to collect data about flammable materials that could pose a fire hazard. Code the agent to move 4 spaces forward towards the dry brush and then analyze the data. Okay, all right, so see, so it's going to move forward and analyze this. And it should just give us the blocks that we need. Agent analyze. Okay. Again, if we just click here, we pop in the agent analyze forward last. Fine. So he was moving forward 4 and then analyzing whatever's in front of him. There we go. Through the gate. Now we need to go up the ladder. And talk to the technician. Let's take the long path. Look over the edge of the building and you will see the agent training maze. Don't worry, you can't fall off. Choose a path button below and move the agent through the maze to reach the dry brush and analyze it. So let's take the long path, why not? We walk right to the edge, we can't fall off. So here's our agent down here. We need to get our agent over here. All right, so forward 2, turn left, forward 4, turn right, forward 2, turn right, forward 4, and so on. So let's break this down. As soon as you go forward 2, turn right, forward 4. Okay. Right, so we're going to move the agent forward 2. And what we're trying to do is just look, if we can kind of see down here, I suppose, as we're coding, that's helpful. So we're going to move forward 2, and then turn the agent left. Then we're going to move forward 4, and turn the agent right, which should take us to here. Then forward 2. Then we're going to turn right, because we should be in this little square here. Then we're going to move forward 1, 2, 3, I think that's 4. Let's give it a go. Move forward 4. And we're going to turn left. Then we're going to move forward 1, 2. And we're going to turn left. We're going to move forward another 2, which should take us to here. And then we're going to turn right, forward another 2. Crikey, it is a long path, isn't it? Forward another 2, which should take us to here. Turn right again, which should take us to here. Then turn, then move forward 1, then turn left, move forward 2, I think, and analyze forward. It's kind of rushing a bit there, but let's see. There we go. Following out the instructions. And this is teaching us, you know, to stack those blocks and get it all done in one. We could move in forward and turn, then code some more and code some more and code some more. But why not do it all in one go? If we can see the path and which way the turns are and how many blocks there are, then we can do that. All right, over to the ladder. Now, I had some students actually struggling to get down this ladder. So do remind them that you just walk up to the edge of the ladder, right up to the ladder, and then actually let go. No W, A, S, or D at that point, just to drop down to the bottom. So then we actually walk through the path that we've just taken, like so. And there's our open gate. And the current quest is go down the ladder and find the head of research. Fire Research Center this way, all right? And there's the head of research waiting for us. Hello. Teaching the agent to predict the fire hazard is our best tool for prevention. Come inside, and the AI specialist will assist you in training the agent. Fine. Current quest, talk to the AI specialist. This computer will help teach the agent about plants that are fire hazards. Watch the images on the monitor. If a plant looks yellow and dry, it's a fire hazard, so press the yes button. If a plant looks green and healthy, it is not a fire hazard, so press the no button. Okay, so this one's green, it's not a fire hazard, so we're going to right click on the no. That one is, so we right click on yes. Okay, and the idea is that we are just training the agent to recognize what is a potential fire hazard and what is not. So we've completed this quest. The next one says talk to the scientist, and he's just over here. So let's see what he's got to say. To successfully prevent fires, the agent will need to remove dangerous plants from the area. Now let's put our training to the test. Code the agent to destroy all the plants that pose a fire hazard. Exit the chat window to start coding. All right, so close this. Here's the agent, so press C. There we go. Eliminate all the hazards. So plants are going to pop up in front of the agent, and we need to program the agent to destroy only the fire hazards. Now we've told him already what the fire hazards are, so we don't need to do that. So let's click here to show a hint. Drag the agent destroy forward inside the box, inside the if block, to ensure the agent destroys all the fire hazards. Okay, so agent detect dry brush forward, then we want to destroy. Okay, so if he detects dry brush forward, then agent destroy forward. And obviously if he doesn't detect a fire hazard, there'll be no destroying, and he will keep doing that until the hazards remain. All right, so as long as there's hazards in front of him, he will destroy them. So let's click play. Destroying the fire hazards and ignoring the non-fire hazards, which is exactly what we want. So the idea is that now this agent is trained to go out into the field and start clearing out fire hazards. There we go. Start clearing out fire hazards in the real world. Next quest is talk to the analyst. What's he got to say? Using images, the agent can now detect where the fires are likely to start. Code the agent to alert the team if a potential fire hazard location is found on the computer monitor. Fine. So let's press C. Let's have a look here. What we've got. We've got an agent looking at a screen. And we want the agent to recognize what a fire hazard is. Alert the team. Okay. So drag the alert team block inside the if hazard found block so that the team can be alerted. So we've got here, when we click the green button, while the agent looks for hazards, if a hazard is found, we're going to alert the team. All right, so the agent's going to sit there looking at the screen, and as soon as it sees a hazard, it's going to tell us. There we go. So wait for him to see something on the screen that looks like a hazard. There we go, and the agent's alerted the team, and the helicopter has flown in, ready to take us over to the location that the agent has identified. So we'll talk to the fire captain. I can't believe how quickly the agent learned to predict fires. We need to hurry to this location at risk of fire. Let me know when you're ready to go. The fire can strike at any moment. Let's go. Right, so we've whizzed over to this location that the agent found for us, and there is a fire hazard, clearly, over here. And what we want the agent to do is get rid of these bits of dry brush and leave the stuff that isn't a hazard, okay? So, current quest, talk to the fire captain. I just got a message from the command center. There's a storm rolling in with a high chance of lightning. We'll need to start clearing the area of dry brush before it gets here. Have the agent clear that line of dry brush to remove a fire risk. Okay, so let's have a look down here and press C. Save the village. So we want him to move forward and do that. Okay. Program your agent to destroy the fire hazards in a row. Click the play button to run your code in game. All right, so we've got some code here already. While fire hazards remained, do an if detagent, if detect dry brush forward, then obviously we want to destroy. Okay, agent destroy forward if we detect it. But we also want the agent to move forward and ignore the potential non-fire hazards, okay? Now, this is a pretty good opportunity to take a look at something that's supplied with this lesson that isn't always easy to find on the Minecraft Education website. So I will attach a link to it in the description. But most of the lessons have these solutions PDFs, like this one. So let's scroll down, solutions here, let's scroll down to saving the village. Right, and we want, that's it, isn't it? Save the village. Fine. So, activity 7, save the village while hazards remain. If the agent detects dry brush forward, then destroy it and move forward by 1. So, the idea is that the agent will move forward by 1, and if he detects dry brush, he'll destroy it, and if he doesn't, he'll just move forward by another 1. Sounds reasonable. So, let's go back to Minecraft and get that set up. Now, that solutions page, of course, you can use, there you go, you can use for your students, if any of them are particularly struggling, if you've got a lot of students, there we go, okay, so the lightning's coming in, you can attach that PDF when you send that work to your students, or you can have it displayed somewhere in the classroom, or you can print a couple of them off and have them lying around. Okay, there we go, so the fire's come. This kind of a fire break there to stop the fire spreading too far. You completed the hour of code. Now look for bonus activities in the village. Talk to the firefighter. Great job you and your agent were able to clear the fire hazards before the storm came and save the village. While you are here, why don't you help restore the area by planting flowers and spawning animals? Explore the village for more coding activities you can try with the agent. We can take a picture there if we want to. Now, we can get involved in some... There we go, that was our picture. We can get involved in some reforestation activities here. There's the agent. So we'll press C to code the agent. And we should reforestation process. So this shows us how to, as we are walking around, be planting trees around us. And again, let's go ahead and look at the solutions page for this. On player walk, place, and then we can place just grass, just a grass block there, immediately below us. So 0, minus 1, 0. And spawn an animal at 0, 0, 0. Okay, so right exactly where we're standing, only when we're walking. So let's go ahead and do a little bit of that. On player walk, we'll get rid of this. On player walk, place a grass block at 0, minus 1, 0. And spawn an animal at 0, 0, 0. Let's close this. We do need to do on start, of course we do. Right, so let's pop the ins on start back in. There we go. So we are putting chickens down and some nice bits of grass. We are basically reforesting the area. And we're getting rid of the fire hazards. Now the students will obviously find this very amusing. And you can change these to trees if you like, and you can change the animals to, you know, dolphins or parrots or something. It's going to entertain the students even more, no doubt. There we go. Ah, we're planting trees down in the ground, so we want to change the coordinates here. For trees, at least, we want to change them to 0, don't we? So that they're not planting underground, ideally. And before you know it, our burnt-out village is looking like a tropical paradise. We've got parrots and chickens and grass and trees all over the place. And the students will enjoy having a play around with this. Get them to have a look around the village. There are some other activities. And later on in this series, we'll also look at the coding town, which has a series of different challenges that these students can partake in. Okay, now I'll leave the link for that solutions PDF in the description to this video. Do take a look at it, please. It's not always obvious the best way to do these. For example, the previous task, you could have got the agent to literally program in and take two steps and destroy some brush just by looking at the order, the sequence of the fire hazards, but of course that's not how we want to do it. We want to automate the agent so it does it by itself. So do take a look at those solutions pages. But that's it for now. Thanks for tuning in. Do like and subscribe so that you can keep track of all the different various lessons that are going on. Thank you.